Coming up next, telemedicine solutions that help bring life-changing health care to rural patients.
The specialists actually spend a good deal of time traveling around, and what they want to be able to do is expand the geographical area that they can service.
Join us to see how the latest in internet video conferencing is allowing specialists to collaborate from all over the world on Health Tech Today. U.S. medical IT focuses on helping medical practices adopt new technologies and make the transition from paper charts to electronic medical records. Dallas Neurosurgical asked U.S. medical IT to help them find a way to reduce the number of times patients in outlying rural areas need to travel to their Dallas office. U.S. medical IT crafted a solution based on Microsoft's unified communications platform, Link. And here to show us how it works is a CIO of U.S. Medical IT, Stephen Cracknell. Stephen, welcome to Health Tech Today.
Thank you very much.
Now, I understand you looked at a variety of video conferencing solutions and you tried some out before you landed on Link. Mm-hmm. What was it about Microsoft Link that really made the difference?
The real breakthrough for us was the high-fidelity application sharing, because for the physicians, it's really about a high-quality image for them to look at to make a determination of what the next steps are in the treatment plan.
And we physicians do like high fidelity.
Yes,
that's really
absolutely important.
Let's take a look at what you're doing.
What we're looking at right here is a high-definition IP security camera that we're using. The reason why we're using it is because it gives the physicians control over the field of view inside the exam room.
You can sweep the whole exam room and zoom in right to the exam table.
That's correct, yes. And then on the screen below, this is where the image of the physician shows up. And so we can have a full face of the physician when they're having a conversation with the specialist, or with the patient. And then down below, we've got a workspace for the physicians. And in that workspace, they're able to look at MRI images, look at lab results, interact with the patient's data. Anything that they bring in with them, they'll be able to interact with on that particular.
So the patient is sitting there on the exam table, and they can see the full face of the physician on that top screen.
Yep.
Conversational, I mean, feel really like that doc's right there with them.
Yeah.
Now, let's take a look at the images, because you do some really cool desktop sharing here.
Yeah, absolutely. So across the top of this is the actual desktop in the Greenville PC room. Basically a toolbar of different tools that the physician can use during the examination. Obviously, the link is what we use to launch the video conference and allow for the application sharing. Next to that is the exam room camera, and if I just pull that up now, this is where we're able to go through and view and scan that particular room. And then on top of that, we have set up a relationship with LabCorp, who gives the physicians access to lab results, no matter where they're taken in the United States or actually around the world. As long as they're put into the LabCorp system, it actually uses Amalga to analyze all that data and present it in a unified fashion for the physician. And so they can actually look at trending data. And if they need to, they can go through and annotate any of the particular images that they want to have a conversation with.
Let's talk about some of the value of this kind of solution. Where do the savings come in? Where does the quality come in?
Sure. The fact that we're using Link allows us to go out and buy off-the-shelf hardware for 95% of the equipment that we're using, and that really drives down the overall cost of the solution.
So it's not telemedicine just for the military or big academic teaching centers. It's telemedicine for the masses, really.
It really is. That's what we're driving towards, a low-cost solution that we can put out into these PCP offices and then give them access to not just Dallas Neurosurgical, but all the specialists that are in the DFW area to allow for that.
And what does it mean to the doctors who no longer have to travel, or the patients also who no longer have to travel?
Yeah, there's two levels to that. The specialists actually spend a good deal of time traveling around, and what they want to be able to do is expand the geographical area that they can service. And so this one focus right now is on the rural areas surrounding the Dallas-Fort Worth area. There's scenarios that we're looking at to give them worldwide access to this
solution. And a doctor driving in his or her car 50 or 100 miles isn't making any money when they're doing that.
No, exactly. So, yeah, this is a solution that helps to drive down the cost for the physicians, increase their billable time.
What about payment? That always comes up with telemedicine solutions. Do they qualify for the CPT code?
Absolutely. They use the same CPT code they would normally use. They just add a GT modifier at the end. They get paid the same amount as they would traditionally.
So tell me a little bit about, I understand that you're also looking at some global opportunity.
We've got one physician that routinely travels over to Saudi Arabia and has a practice over there. We've got two other ones that travel routinely down to Peru to do medical mission trips. We had another group approach us, ISOI. It's a group of 50 physicians. And every month, one of those physicians will travel over to a university hospital in China. Prior to traveling over, they can interact with the physicians and the patients. When they get to China, they can do surgery. And then when they travel back to Dallas, they'll be able to do follow-up visits as well as continue the training they've been doing with the physicians at the university.
Really good stuff. Final thoughts.
Sure, absolutely. So for us, like I said, the big breakthrough was the high fidelity images that allowed us to use this as a platform, and then Link just offers itself up as a great platform to build on top of. So we were able to incorporate the lab results with Amalga and LabCorp. We're experimenting now with Health Vault to allow the patients to log in and show the blood pressure or weight or whatever they've been tracking and give that results to the physician to review as well. The world is open to us now as far as building onto this particular solution.
The world is your oyster.
Yeah, that's right.
Stephen Cracknell from U.S. Medical IT, thanks for joining us on Health Tech Today. Thanks for joining us, and please come back soon for another episode of Health Tech Today. If you have questions or feedback on the show, please leave a comment on my health blog. I look forward to hearing from you.
For more thoughts, comments, news, and reflections on healthcare IT, join Dr. Bill Krause on Health Blog.